Good evening, dear Toastmasters and guests. As you can see, the title of my presentation is What We Can Learn From Con Artists. The reason why I choose this topic is because as you know, we are a public speaking club, and you know that usually con artists are very good speakers. You know, I am sure that at one point of your life, most of you have encountered with a con artist. They maybe try to sell you a timeshare, maybe they try to sign you up for a pyramid scheme. And we know that every once in a while, this type of business idea emerges, and they collect money from thousands of people. And when the bubble bursts, we all wonder, you know, how did this happen? How did people trust them and give their money? Today I will try to explain you the psychological reasons why we trust them and give our money. There are five commonly used techniques that I will show you now. The first one is called the halo effect. For those who don't know what halo is, this is the circle of light that we see above the like angels or holy persons. And this effect is meaning that when we have an overall assumption about somebody, it affects our judgment about that person. For example, if we saw a person dressed really nice, looks very professional, we tend to believe those persons. And therefore, con artists use this method very well. They usually dress really nice. They make them look like they are rich and powerful people. And my advice to you is that if you are going to a business meeting or a job interview, dressing a little bit better will definitely increase your chance to persuade people sitting across you. And the second one is listening carefully. You might say, you know, we always listen. But to be honest, most of us actually don't listen at all. We just thinking about something else, or we are thinking what I'm going to say next. But con artists are not like that. They are very motivated to get to know you. They are trying to find out crucial information about you to use them against you. That's why you need to learn how to listen carefully. Because the word con artist derives from confidence. So if you want to build confidence, the first thing you have to do is to listen and understand the person that you are trying to persuade. And number three is the rule of reciprocity. And reciprocity means like giving the favor back. For example, if somebody give you something for free or do something for you, you are tend to give the favor back to that person. That's why most of the con artists plans always start with something free. Like they invite you for a lunch, maybe they give you a small present, and you start thinking, so this person do something nice for me, maybe I should at least try to listen to him. As the old saying goes, the free cheese is only in the mousetrap. And that's why you should never trust a person that's approaching you something looks too good to be true. And number four is FOMO, fear of missing out. According to research, people's desire to gain something is less powerful than our desire to not lose anything. People hate losing things. That's why almost all of the businesses right now using this method. For example, next time you are trying to book a hotel room, you will see that they always show you these notes like buy it now, like book your hotel now. So they want you to make fast decisions. And usually when you have to make a decision really fast, you usually end up with a bad decision. That's why in your daily life, if you want to persuade somebody, you can pressure them with a time pressure. And the last one is creating the herd mentality. You know, this is a basic human psychology. We tend to follow other people. We trust the people who are trusted by many other people. There is a really good example that I think most of you will remember. Like last year, the government shut down a pyramid scheme organization called Çiftlik Bank. And they had some videos which was filmed in one of their events. Like they gather people around to promote their brand. And in one of the interviews, the guy asked one of the members, you know, why did you sign up to our organization? Why did you trust us? And the woman says, you know, I thought thousands of people couldn't be stupid. and when their organization collapsed, this video was very popular on the social media. So to sum up, I will advise you to try to learn more about how our brains work in order to improve your persuasion and public speaking skills. Thank you for listening.